language.
Behind this unassuming front door lives one of the richest men in Britain. Next door, his pet project is taking shape. This is the story of HeyJo, his exclusive private members club in the heart of London's Mayfair. Dave West is a former barrow boy from Essex. In the past 10 years, he's earned an enormous personal fortune from his cut-price beer and wine business, serving booze cruisers to Calais.
Calais is Europe's beer and wine centre, in the same way as Amsterdam is for drugs and sex, and Paris for romance.
Jo is Dave's girlfriend. She's 24 and from Poland.
So how long have you lived here?
2.5 years.
2.5, that long? Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, time flies, doesn't it?
How did you two meet?
Oh, on the discotheque, of course, in China White.
The social scene here in London is very, very tight. And in fact, how do rich people make friends? You try not to make friends. In fact, you actually distance yourself from people because you don't know what their motives are. So if I've got a nice, good, expensive club, then it's only people that maybe are on par or even better off than me that will come along and be members. The club name is going to be HeyJo.
And the name HeyJo is that?
That's after my fountain of youth.
Dave has decided his new role as club impresario requires a new image, so Jo is taking him shopping.
Oh, Dave, that's the bigger one!
Bigger, bigger. Now, I've got another net, Jo. For many, many years, I walked around virtually like a tramp. I've got a red one, I've got a white one. I want now to have a nice pink one, green, just so I've got a nice different coloured suit for each day of the week. But, you know, being a club owner, you have to be actually some type of an entertainer as well. So I think the suit goes hand in glove with the job and the club.
£34,020 exactly.
£34,020.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, let's make it 34.
34,000. Fine. Okay. Good. Okay. Pleasure doing business.
Thank you very much. Good card. Yeah. Thanks.
I think this company is worth to pay more because they've got really very good quality clothes.
Actually, believe it or not, it's very difficult to spend money. I mean, you know, first of all, I've near enough got everything I want. Eh? It's very difficult to get a balance with people that, for example, you know, going down to Monaco. I would like to invite some of these friends down there, but they couldn't afford the airfare, let alone anything else, and they wouldn't want my charity.
I've joined Dave in Monaco. To promote his club, he's chartered a boat for the Formula One Grand Prix weekend.
Got to have your English cup of tea, haven't you? Hey? All this fancy coffee and all that, it's a little bit too much.
In a prime trackside position, the weekend will cost him hundreds of thousands of pounds.
This is a lovely boat, but, you know, when I arrived here and I saw the boats either side of me, it made me feel like the poor relative.
The Grand Prix will attract many of the world's wealthiest people. Dave hopes to impress some of them to become members of his new club with lavish hospitality. On board is celebrity chef Jean-Christophe Novelli, who may be persuaded to put his name to the club's restaurant.
I think the tricky thing is going to be the kitchen. I can see my part now, because the kitchen is relatively
and I mean relatively very small. In fact, it's like a cupboard. But again, Mr. Novelli, El Mondo Novelli, is going to organize some kind of a trick, like Paul Daniel, and try to make sure the Michelin star service will be coming out from...
Abracadabra.
Abracadabra.
Hello. How are you? You made it. Good.
Yes, I'm on the
boat. Hello there. I'm David. Welcome, champagne.
Dave has managed to attract at least one true blue blood to the party. Jaquetta St. Germans is a real-life countess.
Have you had caviar? Would you like some? And would have you had some of it?
There's only one other taste in this world. Yeah, that comes close, and I can't mention that on the BBC. Here's a shoemaker. Yeah.
That's Jimmy Choo's brother.
It's worth every penny. I can't wait to do it again. I don't understand what's going on. You've got all these racing cars going, and then you've got like a normal car on this thing. Has the race started? I have a wonderful policy in life. I believe in use and be used. Use somebody, and let them use you.
Okay, you mean
that? Yeah. I'm aiming for $250,000 a week.
And it will be.
Yeah.
The kitchen is...